Hello, all of you. Once again, I'm before you to deal with the another concept of economics, which is mainly associated with the quantity theory of money. Dear friends, in the earlier part, I have mentioned about only on the introductory remark on quantity theory of money. What actually the theory states and how it has been elaborated and how the Keynesian thoughts have become a very critics to the quantity theory of money. My dear friends, now I would like to present before you one of the important theory which has made the other theories to develop in the monetary economics, that is Fisher's quantity theory of money. This theory has also been called as Fisher's transaction approach to quantity theory of money. The question comes that who is Fisher? Fisher, the full name of Fisher is Irving Fisher. He belongs to US. In the first slide, I have given a small introduction about the theory. The transaction version of the quantity theory of money was provided by the American economist Irving Fisher in his book, The Purchasing Power of Money, written in the year 1911. Means that the early reference of the theory was made by Irving Fisher by writing his book, The Purchasing Power of Money, in the year 1911. He says that when other things remaining constant or unchanged, when the supply of money doubles, the price level will also doubles, and there is a direct relationship between money supply and price level in the economy and vice versa. It means that there is a direct relationship. Again, I am mentioning the introductory remark of quantity theory of money, where also I have spoke on the quantity theory of money, where it describes about the relationship between money supply and price level in the economy. The same thing has been taken by Irving Fisher in his theory, that he also says there is a direct relationship and proportional relationship between money supply and price level in the economy. Here he says that whenever money supply or money circulation increases, the price level also increases in direct proportion, and the value of money decreases, and vice versa. Here vice versa means whenever money supply falls, the price level also falls, resulting which the value of money will tends to rise. This is what the introduction of the theory made by Irving Fisher. This theory or Fisher's theory can be easily can be taken by his famous equation, that is MV is equal to PT. When we heard about the equation like MV is equal to PT, you certainly should go for Fisher's quantity theory of money, my dear friends. There is no such equation belongs to others. Only MV is equal to PT belongs to Irving Fisher. What actually this MV is equal to PT describes? Please look at the slide. MV is equal to PT, or P is equal to MV by T, where M is the quantity of money, which means that the total volume of money which is in circulation in the economy. V is the transaction velocity. V stands for velocity of money. Velocity of money means the way how money passes from one hand to another hand, the way in which money moves from one hand to another hand in the economy, that we measure it as velocity of money. P is the price level, and T is the total goods and services transacted. In other words, his MV is equal to PT can be also explained in the term like money demand is equal to money supply. Money demand is equal to money supply, or money supply is equal to money demand. Whatever money supply takes place in the economy, the entire will be transacted over goods and services. That's why Fisher's quantity theory of money is being called as transaction approach of quantity theory of money. I hope you understood what, for what purpose his theory is being called as transaction version of quantity theory of money. The answer is he says that whatever money supply takes place in the economy, the entire will be spent over the transaction of goods and services. So there exists no money, there is no money left with the public to save. Here Fisher's equation describes only on transaction value of money, not the store value. This is what the important thing what you have to be kept in mind always. The equation states the fact that the actual total value of all money expenditure, that is MV, always equals the actual total value of items sold. Means that whatever money has been supplied is equal to whatever money has been spent over goods and services. My dear friends, to understand this equation, what's that equation? MV is equal to PT. To understand this equation, you have to clearly focus on the slide what I'm going to show you. Okay, see the slide. Suppose M is equal to rupees 1000. M stands for total volume of money in circulation is 1000. V is equal to 4. V is velocity of money, it is equal to 4. P is equal to price, that is rupees 2. And T is equal to 2000. T here means the total amount of goods has been or have been transacted. The volume of goods have been transacted. It is 2000 units. Thus, if you go with the formula, that is MV is equal to PT, rupees 1000 into 4, 4 is V, where rupees 1000 is M, 4 is V, is equal to rupees 2, 2 is price level of good, into 2000. 2000 is the total volume of goods has been transacted for the existing price level, that is rupees 2. If you reduce or deduce that equation, if you come to the next level, you will get the answer like rupees 4000 equal to rupees 4000. Means MV is equal to PT. Whatever money has been supplied has been spent over the goods and services in the economy. If you go to the another statistics what I have given in the slide itself, if M increases by 50%, if M increases by 50%, that is M rises to rupees 1500. In the initial stage, M was rupees 1000. If it rises by 50,000, it means 50%, it means just add 500 to 1000, that is 1500. Then P will rise by 50%, that is from rupees 2 to rupees 3. Here we have raised both M as well P at the same proportion, that is by 50%. If you come to the next level of equation, that is MV is equal to PT, where you could find rupees 3 equal to 3. Rupees 3 equal to 3 in the last sum, where I have given the answer that 1500 into 4 divided by